Welcome back to KC Talks EV, and yes, we are in the Maxus eDeliver 3. Now, this is the bigger battery variant, so previously it was quoted at 52.5 kilowatt hours, and now it's quoted at 50.23 kilowatt hours. I believe it's just because now they quote usable capacity, and we are about to test that today. First of all, I'd just like to thank Maxus York. They used to be called Clapham Commercial Maxus York. Now they're just Maxus York. They've just rebranded for lending me this van for testing purposes for 3 days. So thank you very much, Maxus York. So on today's test route, we're taking it to Burstall and back. I have got 100% state of charge. I've just basically topped it up at the off spray point. Now, as I've always mentioned in the past, please make sure you don't go to like 100% on your rapid charger. I don't really think it's particularly worth it, but I have done that just for testing purposes today. So I have actually reset the trip computer. I'm starting off 100% state of charge. Unfortunately, this van actually uses kilowatt hours per 100 miles rather than miles per kilowatt hour, but I will be converting it to miles per kilowatt hour and watt hours per kilometer in the tables. So today's weather conditions is approximately 20 to 21 degrees Celsius, and there is a slight crosswind of 11 miles per hour. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so I just arrived here at the Burstall roundabout. I'm now making my way back to Hull. So I arrived here with 57%. My average consumption was 34.9 kilowatt hours per 100 miles. So I will put it in a table outlining what that is in miles per kilowatt and watt hours per kilometer. I've averaged approximately 58 miles per hour. I did hit a bit of traffic as we're coming into Leeds. And I arrived here with 57% state of charge. So let's find out how well we do on the way back. Okay, so we've just arrived here back at Hull. I've done 115.4 miles. We arrived here with 14% state of charge. Unfortunately, about 7 miles into the journey, I accidentally reset the trip computer, but I've just added 7 miles on. It's taken me about 2 hours to do that. I had to stop for 3 minutes to reset the camera. For some reason, it stopped working. So I've just done the maths on it. So if we assume 33.6 kilowatt hours per 100 miles, that correlates to 2.97 miles per kilowatt hour. So if we then extrapolate it, so if we assume we've done 115.4 miles using 84% state of charge, what we find is that we have a usable capacity of 48.03 kilowatt hours of usable capacity. So the next section is we're about to stick it onto a 50 kilowatt CCS rapid charger and then monitor the charge rate. I'm going to go up to my Lidl in Beverly to do the test to hopefully run down the battery a little bit more. So hopefully we'll get there with maybe 5-10%, and then we'll take it all the way up to 90% state of charge. Okay, so we've just arrived here at 9%. I've plugged in, we're already at 10% actually. We're getting 348 volt at 125 amps. I will calculate all of the kilowatt hours at the end of this video in a big table. Okay, so we're at 20 minutes into the test. We're currently at 39% state of charge. In terms of voltage, we're looking at 354 volts and we're still getting a pretty high charge rate, so 125 amps. I probably should also mention though that someone else has plugged in on the AC side, but it doesn't seem to have affected the current so much. Okay, so we're half an hour into the charging curve test. We're at 55% state of charge. So currently we are at 355 volt for the battery voltage and 119 amps. So it has gone down a tiny bit, but it's still pretty good. Okay, so we've just reached the 40 minute mark. We're at 68% state of charge. The battery voltage is 356 volts and we're still getting 119 amps, which is really, really good. Okay, so we just got to 50 minutes. We're at 83% state of charge. Battery voltage is 357 volt and we're still getting 120 amps. So I do want to see when it throttles. So we're at 55 minutes in and it's actually reached 90% state of charge. Now it has actually started to throttle back a little bit, but we're still getting around 105 amps, which is really, really impressive. I normally stop at 90, I know, and then go to the conclusion, but I do want to see where this actually leads. So I'm going to try and go for the full hour and see where it goes from there. Okay, so we're now 57 minutes in. It has started to tail back a fair amount. So it's at 85 amps at the moment, 358 volts, I believe. So I think in the next 2 minutes, we will finish up the test at a full hour and then we'll go straight to the conclusion. Okay, so we've just come up to the full hour at 92% state of charge. I'm about to stop charging. Now, if you really did need the extra range, we are still getting 356 volt at 68 amps. It's just not really worth it to go on a rapid charger. So I'm just gonna finish up the charge and then we'll head straight to the conclusion. So as all the tests have now been completed, you can now have a look at the charging curve test. As you can see, actually, the charge rate is really, really flat and consistent right up until about 90% state of charge. My kind of recommendations from that would be at 90% state of charge, it's not worth going any further. And as a result, just cancel your rapid charge and then be on your way, unless if you really, really need the extra kilowatt hours. So overall, I'd say that's pretty good, especially actually the flat charge curve right until 90%. That will be really good for obviously tradesmen who, you know, are nipping out for lunch, for example, you know, 30, 40 minutes will get you a decent portion, or maybe last mile delivery, you know, having that small amount of time, but a very flat curve is still very, very useful for people. So I think that is pretty much it. So if you liked the video or you found it informative, please give it a like, dislike it if you didn't. If you are in the market for an electric van, please make sure you share this to anyone who is also considering purchasing an electric van. And by the way, I have actually done an initial impressions video of the Maxus eDeliver 3 as well. So make sure you go check that out. Make sure you are subscribed if you haven't already. It really does help me out. And I think that is pretty much it. So thank you for watching and talk to you later.